The Technical University Freiberg is a university dedicated to the field of mining and resources. We in the Computer Science department are especially interested in the application of robots in an underground environment. Lucky for us, our university operates a research mine which we can use to answer some questions. Can robots operate underground? What may be the benefits? And what does it take to deploy robots in such a harsh environment? Therefore, we formed the junior research group Aridua, which investigates synergies between autonomous robots and Internet of Things technologies in underground mining. For now, we focus on autonomy. Our robot is named after Julius Ludwig Weisbach, a former mine surveyor who lived during the 19th century and brought the theodolite to underground mining. The robot Julius is equipped with 4 electronic motors, one for each wheel. Combined, they can produce a torque up to 440 Nm and reach a speed up to 1 meter per second, or 2.2 miles per hour. It weighs around 180 kilograms, or 400 pounds, and has a footprint of 1 meter by 65 centimeters. It features a robotic arm, optical sensors, as well as 2 computers, one of which is dedicated to steering and other critical processes, while the remaining operates complex functions, such as autonomous navigation. Due to the difficult terrain with rails and switches, Julius is remote controlled by a member of the Aridua crew. He navigates the robot to the operation area safely. Today's task is autonomous navigation, which consists of 3 steps: localization, path planning, and execution. For that, the robot uses an RGBD camera and a 3-dimensional LiDAR. The camera is used for the localization and the LiDAR for collision avoidance. In addition, the robot is given a map and images from earlier exploration. This is similar to what miners do. They also look at a map before going underground. On site, the Aridua team designs a trajectory of waypoints. The robot then calculates a path from its current position and starts moving as soon as everybody is ready. Even though Julius doesn't see its destination yet, it uses the given images and map to constantly perform the 3 steps of autonomous navigation mentioned earlier. Going further, we'd like to give an insight into the robot's mind. With its RGB camera, the robot is able to locate itself and see the given waypoint. Once it knows where it is, Julius can project its global navigation map, which can be seen at the bottom. It is, however, a pre-recording, and we have to make sure Julius recognizes new obstacles. For that, it uses its LiDAR, which is visualized at the top. By projecting each point into a 2-dimensional plane, Julius is able to plan a local path efficiently. Despite the harsh conditions underground, like maximum humidity, no light, rough surfaces and puddles, Julius navigates from waypoint to waypoint safely. On the right-hand side, additional information about the local planning algorithm is shown. A collision map is generated by combining laser scans with the robot's proportion. The area between the cyan-colored bands is accessible for the local path planner. In the end, the local navigation path is computed and executed, as shown in the upper right corner. The takeaway is, autonomous navigation based on global path planning and local collision avoidance allow robots to navigate through harsh environments safely. More information about the algorithms and software packages used in our experiments can be found in the description of this video. After Julius arrives safely at its destination, the research team can reconnect and analyze the collected data. Thanks for watching and good luck!